You may be asking yourself, or at least I hope you're asking yourself, hey, but what about error handling? I didn't see a .error method on the end of that call. And you're right, because unfortunately, error handling isn't actually built into JSON P. This is a technical limitation because of what's happening behind the scenes. But there are workarounds like what we're doing here. We can use setTimeout to stop the request if it runs for too long. Before we run this AJAX request, we'll create this setTimeout function. When we bind wiki request timeout to this setTimeout function, we automatically start a timer that will end 8,000 milliseconds later, which is 8 seconds. When 8 seconds are up, we'll go ahead and change the text of the wiki element on the page to failed to get Wikipedia resources. This is a nice fallback. This says that if after 8 seconds have gone by, change the text on the page to this. But of course, there's a problem. If this is all we did, we would, no matter what, overwrite the text inside the Wikipedia element with failed to get Wikipedia resources after 8 seconds. In other words, even if this AJAX request came back successful, this timeout would still occur, these 8 seconds would still pass by, and the text of the wiki element would still change to failed to get Wikipedia resources. So we have to add this line here, called clear timeout, and then pass it the variable name of the timeout we created up here, which is wiki request timeout. This clear timeout will clear or stop this timeout from happening. So inside our success method, we go ahead and append all the articles to the page and then say, hey, stop that timeout. We don't need that timeout anymore. And then it's all good. There are a few different ways we can handle errors with JSON P requests, but I thought this is a pretty easy way of doing it.